It's time once again for our Halloween ride, which is a highway cruise this year. And I'm on this black beast, like a demon from the darkness, and being highway shall scream like a banshee. Actually, it's a Honda Rebel 1100, so while powerful, it'll be a smooth, comfortable, enjoyable ride. On that note, this year, we will not be taking you to any haunted ghost towns. No
tales of death or destruction, murder and mystery.
We're going to see pumpkins.
Evil pumpkins.
They'll probably be fine. Let's ride. No, Trevor. Trevor's our editor. I said we're going to see pumpkins. No need for the warning this year. Okay, let's go. Okay, we're here at Pumpkins After Dark in Milton, Ontario, and we got a chance to catch up with the owner, operator, and chief pumpkineer, James.
So this is the beautiful Country Heritage Park in Milton, Ontario. It is an 80-acre farm just outside of suburbia, so it's a real treasure for the Milton area. Pumpkins After Dark is essentially an art show. We also have live pumpkin carving on site, but the biggest thing that we do are the massive sculptures, some 20 feet high, some 60 feet long, all made, all hand carved right here on site. This is our fourth year, and we have recently done an expansion to Calgary, Edmonton, and Burnaby. Quite honestly, it was just a passion project. I was in advertising my entire career, and I was visiting down in Connecticut, and there Halloween is a really big deal. So I said to my wife, after seeing an amazing pumpkin show, when we get back to Ontario, I am starting my own. And I did, and it started off as a passion project and very quickly became everything that I do. You know, it's so personal. I hear comments every single night of, I like this one the best, I like this one the best. And the ones I like the best, I love the carnival horrors. It's massive, it's both sides of the walkway. It's got moving parts, it's really amazing. And I also love our Jurassic Zone, where we've got a life-size Tyrannosaurus Rex, and Triceratops life-size, so it's really amazing to see. So I have an entire team of artists led by creative director Joe Milana, and they basically start carving the next year's show, probably about November 6th or 7th of this year. After we clean up this show, they'll be starting for next year's show. Yeah, my very first bike, when I saw it, it was the Honda Shadow Ace. I fell in love with it, and I went out immediately, bought it, jumped on it, and just started riding, and that began my my lifelong love of bikes. So we are open this weekend, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and we are also open for our final weekend by request. So many people have requested that we stay open, so we've decided to stay open on Friday and Saturday, the 4th and the 5th of November.
So it is absolutely amazing what they have done with the pumpkins here. The artistry is incredible, maybe a little scarier than I thought, but still fun for the whole family. Remember, you still have a chance to go this weekend if you're in the Milton area or the GTA. Plus, you can find their other locations at pumpkinsafterdark.com.